What's going on? You can't sleep. You have to get up early. Okay. Well, don't worry about it too much. Come on. Come on. You need to sleep. I know you can't. That's why it's time for me to employ my sleep superpowers. Okay, come on. Come on, turn over. Turn over on your tummy. Yes. I'm gonna rub your back and run my fingers along it and tell you another boring story that will make you fall asleep. Well, I'm not gonna get any sleep unless you do, so it's fine. Come on, get cozy. There. You are all tucked in. Okay. Let me see if I can think of a boring story that'll put you to sleep. Okay. I've got one. I know. See, I bet just this would work. But just to make sure, I will tell you one of my famous boring stories. Okay. All right. This boring story is about my first real electric guitar. I used to go to this music store. I guess I was about, I think I started going there when I was about 14. Maybe 15. Just to look at stuff. And when I was 15, I started really playing. So I used to go down there on the weekends all the time and just look at all the guitars. And they were really cool there because they'd let you play anything. Well, almost anything. But I used to go down there and I'd play all the guitars and I'd just sit there and dream that maybe one day I can have one of these. So, I had a shitty job, and I was making really shitty money, and it was part-time, and I mean really shitty money. And I went down there once, and I saw this guitar, and it was, I think it was an Epiphone 295, and it was $185, and I really liked it. It looked so cool. And it was really, really skinny. Which worked out perfect because at the time, so was I. So we were a perfect match. So, I kept going down and playing it, but I couldn't afford it because I didn't have $185. And one day the salesman comes up to me and he says, "Hey, I see you playing that guitar all the time. You really like that one?" I said, yeah, I love this guitar. He said, "Well, it's only $185. You should buy it." And I said, I know, but I don't have $185. And he said, do you have $20? And I said, yeah, I mean, I could get $20 out of the bank. That's about all I have. And he said, well, you can finance it. And I said, what do you mean finance it? He said, you could pay it off over a year. I went, really? He said, yeah. So it would probably be like about $19 a month to pay it off. So immediately, my eyes light up. And I'm really, really excited. And I think, wow, okay. I'm going to get this. I'm going to buy it. So I ran over to the bank and I got $20 and I came back into the store and I said, okay, I have my $20. And he said, okay. So a guy came downstairs from the office and he had to approve it. So I'm standing there and they asked me how old I was and I said, I'm 15. And he said, uh-oh. And I went, what do you mean, uh-oh? He said, well, you're too young to do this yourself. So we'll have to get an okay from your parents. I thought, uh-oh. I don't know if they're going to go for this. So I said, okay, well, you can call my mom. So they did. And I saw him talking on the phone with my mom. And they're talking, and he says, yeah, he really wants this guitar. And then I heard him say, oh, okay. Thank you. And he hangs up the phone. And he comes over to me. And he was playing with me. I wound up buying a lot of guitars from this guy over the years, but this was the first one. And he has this sad, disappointed look on his face. And he looks at me and says, well, I talked to your mother. And I figure, okay, I'm not getting it. And I'm all upset. I said, oh, she said no, right? And he said, no, she said yes. A case for it, and I paid him the $20, and he gave me the invoice, and I did. I paid it off over a year. The funny thing is, I still have the invoice, and if you look at it, right up to the